16th. Ah, there I am. Congratulations. I just love technology. Well, you know my favorite, I miss chalk. Thank you for laughing at that. So we also ask prayers at this hour for all those who are in need of prayers. And in a sense, so many ways, these names are so sacred because they're real people with real stories, real people who have asked to be remembered, to be healed, to be comforted. So for Carol Bartlemy and others recovering from strokes, for their families who stand by their side. For many who ask healing, for Tom and Sue, for Mary, John, and Doris, for Bob Keither, keep Bob in prayers in a special way too, Lindsay Van Ness and Jim Johnson, all struggle with cancers, for Vincent and Don and David, Chris and Parker, for Sarah Johnson, Gavin, baby Kendall, for Judith and Philip and Maria, for Shirley and Liam and Berdiva and Heidi Wood. All have asked prayers. For John Kasurik, who died, may he and his family be filled with light and peace. For Joan Brull, Renee Schermetzler's mom, and Lorraine Ligman, Shirley Fessler's sister, who have recently died, may they be comforted. So we offer these prayers and so many more to our loving God, and we invite you again, as is our custom, to rise, greet your neighbor, that we might begin our worship formally in a moment or two.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Pedro.
Please face the center aisle and join us in singing our opening hymn, number 7, Gather Us In, number 7.
Dreaming.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Gathered together for our Eucharist once again this day, we gather to celebrate the only gift in life that matters, that our God is so deeply in love with us. That love of God fills our heart with great joy. We cannot help but praise and thank and bless. And so once again we pause, we breathe. Let us surrender, empty ourselves, that we might be filled by a gracious spirit, a spirit of love, a spirit of healing and wholeness, a spirit of mercy and forgiveness of our sins. You cast down the mighty from their thrones. Lord, have mercy. You lift up the lowly to high places. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
To the hungry, you give every good thing. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us sing God's praises. Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and Ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us be seated once more to be nourished by God's word.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Wrath and anger are hateful things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance, for he remembers their sins in detail. Forgive your neighbor's injustice, then when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. Could anyone nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon for his own sins? If one who is but flesh cherishes wrath, who will forgive his sins? Remember your last days. Set enmity aside. Remember death and decay, and cease from sin. Think of the commandments. Hate not your neighbor. Remember the Most High's covenant and overlook faults. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. First, if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Peter approached Jesus and asked him, Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive? As many as seven times? Jesus answered, I say to you, not seven times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, the master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full. Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go, released him, and forgave him the loan. When that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, Pay back what you owe. Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, Be patient with me, and I will pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed, and so they went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, You wicked servant, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant, as I had pity on you. Then in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you, unless each of you forgives your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord. Once again, as we gather here, for the third, it's the third scripture in a row that speaks on forgiveness. And what do we have? We have Simon Peter asking a wrong question again. Lord, should we forgive seven times? And in Peter's favor, that would have been generous. Three times would have been the thing. Seven was generous. Jesus said 70 times seven. Okay? He didn't even say yes or no. Do you notice he doesn't answer wrong questions ever? It was the wrong question. I feel bad, and what I feel bad about is that in the translation of this gospel, there's many words that are missing, and I want to fill very briefly tonight. Just my message is so brief. I'm going to have you remember four words again. Remember, stay in the boat. I'm going to have you remember four words, but not yet. The first servant came in to the master, the king, the master, and he owed, are you ready, a huge amount. Oh, that's not what the Greek says. I don't know what language, whether it's Spanish or it's English, I don't care what it is. The original language tells the tale and translates it. A huge amount. I love the old translation because I'm old. 10,000 talents. May I translate that for you? 10,000 talents in our money. Wait for it. I'd love to have you guess how much 10,000 talents is in dollars. You're chicken. None of you are going to take that risk. I don't blame you. You ready? 100 million. 100 million. Over 100,000, 300 denarii. So 100 million denarii. Now you want to work that off? Not a problem. 2,729 years. Do you see how weak this translation is? 2,729 years. Hey, I can do that. And what did he say? He bent down on his face. What would make the master who said, you're going to go to prison, you're going to pay back everything, what made him change his mind? Because the first servant got down on his face and said, long-suffering one, an old title for God. Long-suffering one. That's what he said to the master. Long-suffering one. I will repay you. And the master was moved. I'm going to translate it like it's, I'm going to call it like it is. He was moved from his entrails. I always wanted to say that. He was moved to the deepest compassion I know in Spanish. I'm learning this word too. He was moved to his entrails. I'm going to say this tomorrow. He was moved to his deepest entrails. And he's, are you ready? He released him. He released him. Not just from the debt. He released him. And said, go. I wonder if the first servant really respected his master. Just makes me wonder. He's like, hey, I snowed him, didn't I? I snowed him. He walks out and he sees the second one. Pay back what you owe. Do you know what he owed, by the way? This is great. Do you know what he owed? He owed 100 bucks, 100 denarii that could be paid off in 3 months. Do you see the difference? Pay back what you owe. And what did he do?
What did the master do to the first servant? He released him. What do we do? Oops, sorry. What did the second servant do? He choked him. The master releases, we choke. The master didn't make the first servant feel bad. I'm going to check up on you. You better make sure I'll let you off halfway. The master didn't do that. He released him entirely. He didn't give him the evil eye, like, don't do that again, like I would. I can't speak for you, like I would. Wow. A small debt and a debt that couldn't be paid. The Lord's Prayer, some of our sisters and brothers of other Christian traditions translate it what? Give us this day our daily bread and what? And forgive us our trespasses. Forgive us our debts. I can't stand debt. I can't stand it. Car payments. Ooh. Nobody likes debt. Gotta pay it off. Gotta pay it off. Gotta pay it off. Good. Forgive us our debts. Think of your debts. I want to give you 10 seconds. Just think of one or two, three or four, five or six. I'll look at my MasterCard bill. Oh, okay, here we go. Was God on that list? I don't know God any. We don't. Forgive us our debts. To who? To God. Forgive us our debts. That's a better translation for this gospel. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. We can never ever forgive God for the gift of our life, for the gift of all that we are. We can never say, yeah, that's cool, I can do that. Reminds me of college kids that said, oh, this is nothing, God didn't do anything. Did you ever hear that? So bring a pot of soil to the college kids and say, here, make a person from scratch. Who can do that? I don't owe you anything, really. And in this world, sometimes I think our forgiveness is tight-lipped and it isn't real. Let me close with this. Do you know why Simon Peter's question was wrong? Let's go back to the beginning. Do you know why it was wrong? So wrong? Because he didn't have forgiveness in his heart yet. It was mechanical. It was mental. It was thinking in his mind. Because he put a limit and he said, yeah, I think seven, that's good. Because he wasn't yet thinking the way God thinks. Mercy should flow through us. The same mercy that you and I are shown should flow through us. We should feel it in our entrails when somebody wrongs us or hurts us. I always hear this voice, David, would you freely share with them what I have shared with you? He says that to all of us. Think about the debt. 100 million, 2,700 years to work off. Isn't Matthew genius? Watch The Chosen. Isn't he genius? He figured that out. Look at the juxtaposition. We can never forgive our debt to God. I can't. Why in the world do I have such trouble forgiving the small debts that we incur with one another? I don't know. But all I know is, ever since I studied this text, God is on my list of debts. With my car payment, with my house payment. Nothing on the credit card. That's really fantastic. What do we owe God? Could we ever repay God the debt that we owe? Forgive us our debts. Forgive us our debts. Those are the four words. Forgive us our debts. And that strikes against every chord of individualism we have. I'm not in debt. Bless you. The smallest things. Forgive us our debts. Wow, in light of his love, what more could we ask? Amen. Let's rise and profess our faith once more and proclaim, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. To you, good and gracious God, we turn once more with all our hearts. All we have to offer you of value is our very lives. We ask you to hear these humble prayers that we set before you this day.
That the church serve as a beacon of reconciliation, leading others in the ways of harmony and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations locked in disagreement break the ancient bond of hatred and seek healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who worship God, the God of Abraham, Jews, Muslims, and Christians, foster peace in the world through mutual forgiveness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are burdened by the weight of resentments find solace in today's lesson of compassion and forgiveness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the members of this assembly mirror God's mercy in the way they care for one another, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, for our deceased relatives and friends, for all the intentions in our prayer request book, and in particular, for members of the Steve and Sally Wagner family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, so much in our hearts as we gather here this day, guide us, draw us to you, help us turn to you, for all you desire is to love us, to forgive us, and to once again heal us, we pray, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Let us all be seated once more as our sacred table is clothed and prepared.
Please join us in singing our offertory hymn, number 8, Hosea, number 8.
Rise and pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord
accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just that we should give you thanks and praise, O God, Almighty Father, for all you do in this world through Jesus Christ our Lord. For though the human race is divided by dissension and discord, yet we know that by testing us, you change our hearts to prepare us for reconciliation. Even more, by your Spirit, you move human hearts, that enemies may speak to each other again, adversaries join hands, and peoples seek to meet together. By the working of your power, it comes about, O Lord. Hatred is overcome by love, revenge gives way to forgiveness, and discord is changed to mutual respect. Therefore, as we give you ceaseless thanks with the choirs of heaven, we cry out to your majesty here on earth without end and sing. You, therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He is the word that brings salvation. He is the hand you stretch out to sinners. He is the way that leads to your peace. When we ourselves had turned away from you, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that, converted at last to you, why we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating this great gift that Christ has brought us, we entreat you. Sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, on that very same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. celebrating therefore the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you, accept us together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people, and may he keep us in communion with Francis our Pope, David our Bishop, and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, Thomas, and all the saints, and yes, with our brothers and sisters, and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. Let us rise, for it is at the Savior's command and formed by his divine teaching that we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord Jesus be with you all. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. We behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those now called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us all unto everlasting life. Amen.
Please join us in singing communion hymn number 9, Psalm 103, Loving and Forgiving, number 9.
Oh,
Just a couple of notes before we conclude. Don't forget, as Deacon Steve mentioned last weekend, this Tuesday right here in this space, will be a one-person play on about Dorothy Day, about her life and her faith and the struggles in her life, and just a marvelous, marvelous play. I haven't seen it. Deacon Steve said he has seen portions of it, and he said it's just incredibly enlightening. So Dorothy Day, member of our church, her whole life turned around as she worked for others and served others by giving her life. Not as a martyr, but as giving her life in service, okay? So please, if you can come, that's Tuesday night here in this space. And again, I didn't write the time down, so my poor brain, but that's what happens today. So, do you know?
6:30.
Thanks, 6:30. Thank you, Kevin, 6:30. Kevin isn't shy, that's good. Because I'm getting old, I need somebody to help me. So it's at 6:30 right here. Again, there's no cost to this, but a free will donation will be to help the Manitowoc Warming Shelter. And again, that's to help folks continue, not just to get on their feet and to be helpful and to live their lives. So again, you can just walk right in. And if you want to make a donation to the warming shelter, that would be great. That's the price, okay? And there really isn't. Finally, what I wanted to share with you also is Amar Jasmi, who coordinates our script program, is to help to share with you that last week here at the church, last week, the script profits alone were $1,000 in a week, just in a week. And she wants me to encourage you to remember that Quick Trip is doubling for the month of September. So again, if you use Script, if you don't, please ask at the window. It's real easy to use, and it's your own to use. So please help as you can. That's a beautiful way to help our church continue to grow, at least financially, okay? Are there young people ages 3 to 12 that would come sit with me at the step just for a moment? All right, ladies. It's not easy, is it? It sometimes just isn't easy. Here's the whole point. Tomorrow morning I'll do this. They'll be surprised. One sentence. If God could forgive such a big $100 million debt and not bat an eyelash, can you imagine that? That's a huge $100 million. I can't imagine how much money that is. I just can't, okay? I can't. I grew up with a piggy bank. There wasn't even a way for me to get the money out. I had to use a knife. How much God forgives us. And you know what God wants us to do? Seriously? Jesus just wants us to forgive other people like he forgives. That's the challenge. Can I forgive you like he forgave me? Without strings, nothing. You don't even have to get down on your face in front of me. All he says is, will you forgive others the way I forgave you? That's all I wanted to say today. Nothing more. Okay? $100 million. Whew, that's a lot of cash. You are... Let's see. Would you... How are we doing? One more. Oh. Yes, you may. Want to pass that down? And would you pass that down? And would you pass this down right next to you? Right next to you. That's right. And that's for you. Thank you for coming to the step. Let us rise, let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Let us go in peace now, glorifying the Lord by our very lives. Thanks be to God.
Please join us in singing our closing hymn, number 11, City of God, number 11.